Hi students, welcome back to BTech Mathematics again. In this video, we are going to discuss a problem from complex analysis that was asked for third semester BTech students, those who are studying or have completed their third semester, those who are studying in 2019 syllabus or those who are studied in 2015 syllabus, all have to write this portion from complex analysis, and it's an important question too. Okay, and this particular question from 2020 December supplementary examination for third semester students, and this comes under the module 1 complex differentiation of 2015 students and module 3 complex differentiation of 2019 students. Okay, we have already done all the videos, all the modules of 2019 syllabus S3 students. You can check the video from the playlist, and I also include their links in the description box module wise. Okay, now we are moving to the question. Find the analytic function f of z that is equal to u plus iv, whose real part is given as e raised to minus x into x cos y plus y sin y. It's an important one, and we have given that the real part of this complex function. We have to find this complex function f of z, and we have given the real part of this complex function e raised to minus x into x cos y plus y sin y. Okay. Now we use Milne-Thomson method to find the complex function f of z, and for that you have to differentiate this function. You have to find the first partial derivatives, dou u by dou x and dou u by dou y, and I will find dou u by dou x, that is ux. You have to use product rule to differentiate this function, because these two functions, e raised to minus z and this x cos y plus y sin y, both contains x, isn't it? Therefore, I am using product rule. First function, e raised to minus x into derivative of this function, x cos y. Here, cos y is a constant. We can take it outside. Cos y into derivative x is 1 plus, this is a constant function without any x variables. Therefore, its derivative will be 0. Okay, we finished first function into derivative second, plus we have to take the next portion, second function into x cos y plus y sin y into derivative of the first e raised to minus x. What is derivative? E raised to minus x. Derivative of e raised to minus x is e raised to minus x into minus 1. Isn't it? Now we can have this as e raised to minus x into cos y minus e raised to minus x into x cos y plus y sin y. Okay, now we'll find dou u by dou x or u x at z 0. That is, we are going to substitute z for x and 0 for y. Therefore, we'll get e raised to minus z into cos 0 minus e raised to minus z into cos y is cos 0 plus 0 sin 0, isn't it? Now we can simplify this function. Now this is equal to e raised to minus z into cos 0 is 1 minus e raised to minus z into 1 plus 0. Therefore, this is equal to e raised to minus z minus e raised to minus z into z. This is u x at z 0, isn't it? Now we'll find u, derivative of u with respect to y, that is dou u by dou y. U y we'll find, u y equals, here e raised to minus x is a constant, considering y as a variable, e raised to minus x is a constant, we'll take it outside, and x is again a constant, x into, what is the derivative of cos y? Cos y, derivative of cos y is minus sin y, plus to differentiate this y sine y, we use product rule. First to function into derivative of sine y with respect to y is cos y, plus second function sine y into derivative y is 1 with respect to y, isn't it? Now this is equal to e raised to minus x into minus x sine y plus y cos y plus sine y. Now we'll find dou u by dou y or u y at z 0. Again, replace x by z and y by 0. E raised to minus z into minus z sine 0 plus 0 into cos 0 plus sine 0. That is equal to e raised to minus z into minus z into sine 0 is 0 plus cos 0, 0 into cos 0 is 0 again, and sine 0 is 0. Therefore, all this function becomes 0. Therefore, dou u by dou y or u y at z 0 is 0. And now we know that the functions f of z, if you consider the function f of z, it is u plus iv, isn't it? Now we'll take its derivative f dash of z with respect to x. Therefore, you will get ux plus I into vx. Okay, ux plus I into vx. And since it's an analytic function, it satisfies Cauchy-Riemann equation. What is it? Cauchy-Riemann equation is ux equal to vy and uy equal to minus vx. From this, we'll replace this minus vx, or from this we can write vx is equal to minus uy. Okay, now we'll substitute this vx equal to minus uy in this function f dash of z. Therefore, f dash of z becomes ux minus I into uy, isn't it? Now we'll substitute all this ux and uy at z 0. Therefore, before that, we can write f dash of z at z 0. F dash of z at z 0 is ux at z 0 plus, or instead, minus I uy at z 0, isn't it? Now we are substituting the function ux at z 0 and uy at z 0. Ux at z 0 is e raised to minus e raised to minus z into z. That is e raised to minus z minus e raised to minus z into z minus I into uy at z 0 is 0, isn't it? Therefore, the function f dash of z is e raised to minus z minus z into e raised to minus z, isn't it? Now we need to find the function f of z. For that, we will integrate this function, integral f dash of z. Therefore, you will get it as f of z. F of z will be integral f dash of z dz. Now this is equal to integral e raised to minus z e raised to minus z dz. We'll integrate this function with respect to z. What is the derivative? What's the integral of e raised to minus z? E raised to minus z is minus e raised to minus z by minus 1 minus. Here we want to use integration by parts or the chain rule of integration. For that, we'll consider z as a first function, z into integral of second e raised to minus z by minus 1 minus derivative of the first function, that is 1 into integral of the second function in the bracket e raised to minus z by minus 1. Already minus 1 is there, therefore it becomes plus 1, plus derivative of 1, which is 0. Therefore we'll stop here, and this will be minus e raised to minus z minus minus z e raised to minus z minus e raised to minus z. This will be the function. Now we'll expand this. We'll multiply this minus z into the bracket, minus e raised to minus z plus z e raised to minus z plus e raised to minus z. We'll also add a constant of integration, isn't it? After integrating, we'll add a constant of integration. C plus C will be here. And this is our f of s, f of z. Therefore, we can cancel this minus e raised to minus z and plus e raised to minus z. Therefore, our function f of z, the complex function f of z is z e raised to minus z plus constant of integration C. This is an important question, and this will be the answer. And this asked for the 2020 December supplementary examination for 8 marks. Okay, this is a question of 8 marks. I think the question is clear for you, and we'll meet with more questions in the next video. Thank you for watching.